So here we are, we've just landed in Portugal, in Faro, as we can see, the boys here. All the bikes have just been dropped off, we've got the panniers sorted. And we're about to head to the Spanish border. So that's going to be, we're getting a train. So yeah, we're going to head on to the Spanish border for the night and then kick things off in the morning. As you may have guessed, the weather is worse here than it was in Manchester when we left. John assures me it's not going to rain. It's not going to rain, is it, John?
It's not
going to
rain.
It's not going to rain. So we're going to see how that turns out tomorrow. But yeah, good stuff. We've got Chris and Iain in the back there. It's silent so far because they're not on Facebook. But there we go. I'm sure you'll see much more of them over the next few days. Yeah, so that said, we'll catch you in the morning for the start of the challenge. Just made it to Faro Airport, and John, I hate to alarm you, this looks a little bit more severe than a bit of mist off the coast.
It will, mate.
It's not going to rain. So, welcome to day one. It is Saturday the 21st of April, and it is 7:23 in the morning. We decided that it's best to set off early because, I don't know if you can see, we are looking like we might get some thunderstorms today. So, yeah, in a moment we're going to head over to GoPro Cam and see how 50 miles goes this first day.
Okay, and what actually happened was Dave made the GoPro stuck in time-lapse mode. So you get a nice voiceover. This is us setting off from Villarreal. And as you can see, the weather is okay, but it's not great. And it gets progressively worse. The thunderstorm that we can see out in distance gets closer. And then we head off down some dirt tracks, and obviously this dirt and gravel's turn into sand and slush, and it's hard going. And then this bit is the really annoying bit. This is where the thunder and lightning get really, really close, and the flashes would have been so good on the GoPro, but it's time lapse and slowing it down just doesn't work.
So John, give us a situation report about how it's gone so far.
Well, it's gone really well actually. We set me up at,
up early, about 7-ish, weren't we?
About 7-ish, yeah. We got breakfast an hour earlier. The hotel put a special breakfast on for us. And got the bikes out. Few drips of rain, but nothing too serious.
Did you use that R word? I think it was...
Hammond clock pulled out my shoe.
We are really just sheltering from the thunderstorm because Iain is scared of the lightning. Actually, it's me that's scared of it.
But it's not going to rain, so we're all a bit alright.
That was rain running down your face.
Yeah, it is.
It's ocean spray.
Yeah.
How are we doing, boys?
Alright, very good.
That was a nice hill, that, John.
Yeah.
Appreciate that.
It's just a wee one. It's more
of
that.
Mister, it's largely flat. So, day one, just stopped at Tampoc Cabanas for breakfast. The weather, as you can probably see, is a little bit small, but we carry on the same. I want to ride my bicycle. I want to ride my bicycle. I want to ride my bike. I want to ride my bicycle. I want to ride it where I like. You say bicycle.
So we have made it to Faro. This is the end of day one. It's now 6:30. So as you can probably tell, today didn't go to plan. We had a couple of nice stops along the way, which was great. And about 3 miles outside of Faro, where we are now, my chain snapped on a dual carriageway. And the other guys were ahead of me, and I couldn't shout, they couldn't hear me due to the traffic. So luckily a local man stopped, offered to help. He didn't have the thing that we needed, but he went up and caught up with the guys. Chris then came back and walked with me up to the off the dual carriageway. And John luckily was able to fix the chain, or at least temporarily fix the chain, enough to get us home. I'm not a big cyclist, but this is the first broken chain that John's come across. I'm not sure how common they are. But yeah, it's been a tough last few miles, and obviously I added much more time onto the journey than we would have liked. Good news though is that a new bike is getting dropped off tomorrow for me. So it will not impede the journey. Life will carry on, and we will continue smashing this challenge. I now need a shower. We're going to go and grab something to eat, have a few drinks, and then get ready for day two. Who said this was going to be easy? Okay, so showered, now ready to go out, and I quickly wanted to say, like, sort of share my thoughts and how things are going. Firstly, John, Iain and Chris. I've never met Iain and Chris before. They are fantastic guys. Couldn't have wished for nicer people to be doing this challenge with. And secondly, it's hard. It is harder than I imagined. 20 miles on a watt bike in the gym feels a lot shorter than 20 miles on a real bike on dirt tracks, up hills, down hills. So yeah, it's definitely a challenge. Like today I thought, yeah, I'll be fine. The first day won't be too bad. The first day today was harder than I thought it was going to be. Who knows what tomorrow's going to be like. I imagine my legs are going to be killing in the morning, and within the first half a mile, I'm going to really, the pain is going to continue on from the end of today. Hopefully I'm wrong. Yeah, this is not easy. For me, like I said, I'm sure there's people out there who cycle, you know, these distances every weekend without a problem. But for me, having not been on a real bike in about 3 years, this is a challenge. And but we're going to do it. There's failure, like I said, is not an option. Giving up is not an option. And like I said, if this challenge takes me fucking 2 weeks, I'm going to do it. It won't take me 2 weeks, but even if it does, even if I have to crawl and drag the bike to that end point, I'm going to finish it. I'll see you guys tomorrow. Guys, day two, how are we feeling?
Excellent. Smashing.
Okay, so they're liars, is what that is. Yeah, we've had the new shiny bike delivered and ready to crack on with day two. Got to say, not feeling too bad for this morning. Feeling better than expected, but we'll see how quickly that last one can start pedaling. Yeah, let's see how day two goes. Another 50 miles today, ending in 14 mile. And we are back again. Now this is a clip where we actually took the wrong way around the airport and had to go back on ourselves. And I want to slow this clip down because this is a bit where, as you can see, Chris is balancing on this wooden pole, and I hate time lapse because he loses his balance and snaps the pole there. And that would have been so good if I actually had that on proper film, but it was only on time lapse and you sort of lose it. But anyway, back to the going around the airport, and again, the rain caused us lot of wet sand, it's just horrible stuff to be riding through. And it felt like it took us absolutely ages to get around the airport. But yeah, anyway, I think at this point I realised I had to switch it to video settings. So from now on, it should be sort of better quality, less jerky. And yeah, we'll see how that goes.
Seeing that snake in the grass.
Chris's. Chris, can you see a snake in the grass on just on the other side? Yeah, it was, wasn't it? Yeah, big one. Turning to Steve fucking early. No, no, it genuinely was a big snake. Yeah. I've no idea.
Take
that, you twat! Pros on. How are you feeling midway through day two?
Upset.
Oh. Do you reckon we're at least at the halfway point? No, I mean for like the total trip. Today's 50-ish, tomorrow's 50-ish, yeah, so almost a month, 25 today. Yeah. It's these long, slow inclines, and we've not got any momentum. John, now in Albufeira, how's it going?
Let's get one and support them out. This broadcast is brought to you by the Albufeira Tourist Board.
Oh dear, now we did stop, where did we stop earlier?
Villamora.
Villamora, I forgot to like give an update, but we stopped in Villamora after it took 3 days to get out of Faro. And I feel like we made good progress after that. We're about halfway.
About halfway, yeah. Give it 2.5 hours, we'll be there.
So we've got about 20 odd miles to go. So a couple of hours. Hopefully, we know no issues, we should be at Portimão. Yeah?
Yep.
Fingers crossed. Fingers crossed everyone's arse and legs hold up until then.
In the pub by 7.
Although we have got the longest hill in the world, apparently, on the way out of Albufeira, so that'll be fun. Yeah, we'll no doubt go back to some GoPro footage of the journey.
It'd be good, wouldn't it? Yeah. Worst places to be lost. Where's that end on to? I've been going around in circles for the last 20 minutes.
I want to ride it where I like. So we are now in day three. We're in Portimao, and ready to head off to the end point. There was no update last night because basically we're all fucking dead. It was about 12 hours yesterday on the bike.
12 hours.
How are we feeling, guys? How are we doing?
Tell you what, we should be feeling better. At our age, at the prime of youth, we should be feeling
a lot better. A knee transplant, two knee transplants. Yeah.
Well, we're at it. Yeah. An arm as well.
But last day, so, and the weather's decent.
The weather's lovely, actually. It's a good start to the day. Well,
let's do it. So,
Situation report is we're about 26 miles into today and John picked up a puncture.
Okay, no worries.
Currently trying to flag down locals because we don't have a spanner to get the wheel off the bike. And self-adhesive patches are not holding as the puncture is right across the seam. So, John's currently trying to talk into locals. Yeah.
Oh, you star, thank you very much.
We might have some luck.
Buy your pints. People are kind.
What did he say? What did he say, John?
It's an import bag with an adjustable spanner in 5 minutes.
What a legend. Yeah. What a legend.
Bag with just like a thong and a gimp. You can have the spanner, boy.
So what needs adjusting?
See what tube looks like then, the other tube.
I'm all for this, by the way, because we have to go up that hill. So, you know, the longer we're here, the longer we're not going up that hill.
No. I remember him having a spanner in his hand and said, oh, you don't need a spanner. So he obviously assumed it
all quick release. What beautiful countryside we're in.
So it's got stolen but something got holiday insurance, mate.
Oh dear. Is it a crisis? That's the question.
It is a crisis. This is, it's a mini.
Do you reckon there's a small spanner in the envelope? Did they predict what was going to happen? John, maybe you should open.
Let's open it.
Luxury spanner.
Thank you. Okay, very nice. Bumblebee.
Oh yeah.
Nice. Flowers, yeah. Bit feminine for us, but you know.
I'm comfortable. It's all good.
Whenever you find yourself doubting how far you can go, just remember how far you've come. Remember everything you've faced, all the battles you have won, and all the fears you have overcome. The Get Your Belly Out community is with you every step of the way. You've got this.
Oh, wow.
There's loads of people. Richard, Stuart, Laura, Andrew. As much good as a chocolate firefighter.
You mean there was no spanner? But joking apart, it's very nice. It's a very nice card.
It's the right thing for words.
Time for speaking is over. Move on action, but here he comes. Here he comes.
Is this the guy? Watch him just drive past, stick two fingers up. Fuck you and your spanner.
This could be the guy.
Oh dear. All our shadows disappeared, the animals inside came out to play. Went face to face with all our fears, learned our lessons through the tears, made memories we knew would never fade. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. He took me in his arms, I heard him say, when you get older, your wild heart will live for younger days. Think of me if ever you're afraid. He said one day you'll leave this world behind, so live a life you will. Can't put out, carve your name into those shining stars. He said go venture far beyond the shores, don't forsake this life of yours. I'll guide you home no matter where you are. One day my father, he told me, son, don't let it slip away. There we go, we made it. We made it to Cabo Saint, whatever this lighthouse is. Apparently it's the most southwesterly point in mainland Europe. There you go, we did it. It was hellish, horrendous. But now we've got to cycle 5 miles back to find the nearest civilization. So there it is, we've done it. We're now back in the hotel in Faro. Got a little bit of panda tan from the glasses. Today was hot. We had a lot of sun today. But actually, what I want to do is take this back to yesterday when we arrived in Portimao. I didn't actually record a video for you, or like an end interlude, because we'd been cycling for about 12 hours that day. We set off at 8:30. In the morning when my new bike got dropped off, and we didn't arrive in the hotel in Portimao until I think it was 8:30, 8:45. So it was a solid 12-hour day. We did obviously have a couple of stops, but it was tough, man. About 80% of the roads were like gravel, dirt tracks. There's lots of uphills, lots of scrambly sort of routes. It was some tough going, and like I said, after yesterday, I was like, God, you know, and legs were aching, my ass was aching. It was really tough going, but we made it, and I was genuinely concerned that today when we woke up, I would be, you know, there was an element that went, am I physically going to be able to do this today? And then last night didn't help, or this morning, our hotel in Portimao was right opposite a nightclub, and I was like, it's Sunday night, it'll be fine. It wasn't fine. Music was blasting, various rowdy people chanting, football sorts of hooligans sounding, and then the seagulls, because it was near the beach, and it was, me and John both said, like, we didn't get a lot of sleep last night. And Chris as well, he said he didn't get... Iain slept great. Iain was a different hotel. He had a very, very nice room. He slept good. But yeah, me, Chris and John, we struggled last night. And I was like, ah. And then this morning, it was going so well. We smashed about 12 miles in. We got to Lagos and had breakfast. And we're like, yeah, this is great. And then that's largely because we were taking the motorway routes on the road, and then we joined the cycle track again, and there was some horrendous hills. And whilst there was no real dirt tracks or gravel roads, we're talking like 20%, if not more, inclines. 20 degrees incline, not 20%. Hell, you can tell I'm a little bit delirious. Today was the hottest day by far. The sun was out pretty much most of the day until we got to the end. That last 5 miles that you've just seen was
was pretty tough, and apologies, mate, I need to go and sort that out. It was really tough. Then we had to go 5 miles back to the town in order to get transport back to where we are now. Oh, just found another mosquito bite. Nice. So, like an update, my legs, arms, neck, because my neck has been constantly like that while I've been cycling. So my neck's sore, my both legs are sore, my arse is sore. I've got 2 mosquito bites, just found one. But it was worth it. It was definitely worth it. Would I recommend you do it? Absolutely not. Don't do it. Don't do this bike route. If you don't have to do it, don't do it. It's not fun. It's not fun. But there's definitely a sense of accomplishment. And just as I've been recording this video, we've just had the final donation from Lisa, who was the inspiration for doing all this, that has taken us to £1,300 raised. From myself, John, Iain and Chris, that is a huge amount of money. You know, 130% of our target, and you know, hopefully it'll go towards finding a cure for Crohn's and colitis. Also want to say a special shout out to the Get Your Belly Out crew. They've been keeping us up to date and motivating us. And as you'll see, as you've seen in the clip, when we opened the envelope, we had the crisis, we had the puncture. And we joke, we were being sarcastic. Like, oh, it's usually, it was very kind, it was very nice, it was great motivation to see all the names of all the people that go through struggles. Much like we've been through for the past 3 days, but the thing is that in the next few days, we'll heal, we'll get better. And for everyone who's on that card, this is a lifetime, you know, what's the word? It's a lifetime sentence, basically, as it stands right now, and that's obviously what this was all in aid of trying to fix, was to find a cure. I'll leave the Just Giving link open. It's justgiving.com/fundraising/Portugal2018. Link will be down below as well. Please donate whatever you can. I'll leave it open for a few more weeks, and hopefully some people will see this and be urged to donate. I'm going to go out now and grab a few beers. Thank you. Job done. He said one day you leave this world behind, so live a life you will remember. My father told me when I was just a child, these are the nights to never die. My father told me. Bicycle.